Professor Daria, a lot of us, presentation is going to be I am going to present as a pre-recording. She is from East Kazakhstan State Technical University, Kazakhstan, from the Kazakhstan. As an invited speaker, her topic is using SEM to select the optimal parameters for mycoplasma spraying and characterize biocompatible coatings.
Dear participants of the Congress, I am glad to present here a joint study of Kazakhstani and Ukrainian scientists using scanning electron microscopy to select the optimal parameters for mycoplasma spraying and characteristic of biocompatible coatings. My name is Daria Lotsova. I am a tenured professor of physics at East Kazakhstan Technical University with 15 years of experience in developing new technologies for plasma surface treatment. I am quite dedicated to the use of electron microscopy to develop these technologies. In the past years, as an invited speaker, I have already had the honor to share at the Congress my experience about using transmission electron microscopy for the analysis of thick plasma coatings. My talk today focuses on using scanning electron microscopy to plasma coatings analysis. First of all, I'd like to tell you about the background of the current research. Several years ago, this in the framework of the project, the state funding of the Republic of Kazakhstan, we launched a production site of our university for the pilot manufacturing of medical implants to develop cheaper and patient-specific medical implants. We pursued two approaches, implant lathing by numerically controlled machines, followed by surface purification and quality control, and mycoplasma spraying of biocompatible titanium or zirconium or tantalum wires onto implants used in industrial robot. Our goal is process optimizing and prototype development. You can see here our main technological and analytical equipment, namely the CNC turning and milling machine produced by DMG Mori, Germany. Mycoplasma unit produced by Paton Institute of Electric Welding, Ukraine. And Kawasaki Industrial Robot Manipulator, produced by Kawasaki Heavy Industries, Japan. And our main analytical equipment used for this research. Transmission electron microscope. X-ray diffractometer, scanning electron microscope, etc. Kazakhstan Research Institute of Orthopedics and Traumatology provided us with modified medical implants, and we made prototypes on endoprosthesis on CNC machines. After that, the surface of the implants needs additional processing. The implant surface is the first to come into contact with living tissue, then the implant is placed in the human body. So the initial reaction of living tissue to the implant material depends on the properties of its surface. Coating the surface of medical implant with biocompatible materials can improve its biological activity and also inductivity. We focused on mycoplasma spraying of biocompatible coatings on the pre-gas abrasive treated implant surface. The surface roughness of implants affects the response of cells and tissues. The increased roughness increases the surface area of implant adjacent to the bone. thereby improving implant fixation and bone. Nowadays, different combinations of various materials and coatings methods are used to achieve optimal for a particular implant chemical and physical properties of the surface. As I noted earlier, we choose microplasma spraying. Microplasma spraying is a type of gas thermal spraying. During spraying, powder or wire particles melt in the plasma jet and move toward to the substrate, heat it, deform, and form a coating with a typical lamellar structure. Currently, gas thermal spraying methods are widely used in applications related to the metalworking industry. Yet for the medical field, it is an innovative subject with opportunities that are currently being studied. There are some advantages in using microplasma spray. First of all, it is possible to avoid volumetric heating of the implant due to the low power of the process, up to 2 kilowatt. Secondly, the small size of the spray spot on the plasma-coated surface with a diameter of 5 mm to 15 mm reduces the loss of the sprayed material than coating small-sized products, which include most endoprosthesis parts. The use of robotic microplasma spraying allows for precision spraying of coatings on parts of complex implants, such as parts of elbow and hip joints. In our previous study, it was shown that robotic microplasma spraying can produce coatings on medical implants made of biocompatible titanium and hydroxyapatite materials with the desired porosity and roughness that meet the requirements of international standards for implants in surgery. There are two options for using the robotic arm here. The first is to install the microplasmatron on the arm and move it, or move the workpiece in the plasma stream, as you can watch in this video. In our research, we preferred the first option, so we installed the microplasmatron on robot arm. Nowadays, there is an increased interest in using zirconium as a material for medical implants. Due to its high strength and chemical stability, zirconium is promising as an orthopedic biomaterial. According to modern research in this field, coatings for orthopedic implants should be porous with porosity of at least 20% and with porous size from 20 micrometer to 200 micrometer, so that bone tissue and blood vessels can grow through them. Since, in principle, methods of thermal plasma spraying allow obtaining coatings from a refractory material such as zirconium, we set the goal of our research. First of all, to check the possibility of microplasma spraying, MPS, or zirconium coating on titanium alloy substrates, and to establish a correlation between zirconium coating porosity and MPS parameters in order to form on titanium substrates zirconium coatings with the desired porosity suitable for biomedical applications. The coatings were deposited by MPS of zirconium wire onto substrates for medical titanium alloy, as you can see on this slide. Before microplasma spraying, a gas abrasive treatment of substrates was carried out. The coating experiments for MPS of zirconium wire were accomplished in a two-level fractional factorial design. The following parameters were chosen as a variable parameters: electric current, plasma gas flow rate, spray in distance, and via fluoride. No clinical tests on humans or animals have been carried out. The study of coatings and particles microstructures has been carried out with the use SEM, GSM, Geol, Japan. SEM images were taken from the cross-section and the surface of each coating. SEM images of coating cross-sections were processed using ImageG software to evaluate the porosity of the coatings as per STM standard. In order to study the size and morphology of particles formed during wire spraying, the spray products were captured in a container with water, filtered, dried, and then their sizes were measured. The splat test method was used to study the state of particles of the sprayed materials after impact with the substrate. Microplasma spraying of zirconium wire on titanium substrates was carried out according to the matrix of the experiment, which you can see here. The coating thickness was varied from 150 micrometers to 500 micrometers by changing the parameters of MPS. The speed of linear movement of the microplasmatron along the substrate was chosen to be 50 millimeters per second. As you can see, zirconium particle sizes are highly dependent on the parameters of MPS. In the case of a combination of the maximum values of the electric current and plasma gas flow rate, as in run 1, the minimum average particle size was obtained. It was exactly 128 micrometers. The combination of the minimum values of these operating parameters results in the formation of particles with maximum sizes of 310 micrometers, as in run 7, and 268 micrometers, as in run 8. It should also be noted that using the parameters of run 8 leads to the formation of spongy particles with a rough surface, while MPS in run 4 leads to the formation of spherical, smooth particles. The results of measuring the porosity of coatings and particle sizes of the sprayed zirconium wire for various spraying parameters are presented here. Regression analysis of the dependence of the average particle diameter on the MPS parameters made it possible to obtain the equation 1. As follows from equation 1, the main ways to control the size of the sprayed particles is to change the electric current and plasma gas flow rate. The structure of the coating depends on the size, shape, and speed of these particles, as well as on their condition at reaching the substrate. There the particle can arrive molten or semi-molten or softened, which is important for adhesion. Investigation of state of the particles of the sprayed zirconium wire after the collision with the substrate has been carried out using the splat test. The splats are single particles of the sprayed material fixed on the substrate and deformed upon contact with the substrate surface. You can see here that the wire particles upon collision with the substrate were completely melted and formed disks. This form of splats means that the particles were in molten state before colliding with the substrate. At the same time, the fact that the splats in run 4 have more metal splashing at the edges suggests that they were in a higher temperature due to the shorter spraying distance. The splats obtained in different runs had similar area but different thickness. same images of zirconium's plots, cross sections, and surfaces of zirconium coatings spread with rank 1, 4, 7, and 8 are shown here. The analysis of same images allowed us to identify three main groups of microstructures of coatings dependent on the spraying parameters. The first group. If the particles are completely melted when approaching the substrate, as in rank 1 and rank 4, then the dense coatings with the average porosity of 2.8% are formed. The second group. If when approaching the substrate, together with the molten particles, there are particles that have begun to solidify, as in rank 7, then the coating structure is characterized by the presence of pores. The average porosity is 8.3%. Group 3. If coatings are formed from particles that have begun to solidify at a low speed, as in rank 8, then such particles form a porous coating with the highest average porosity of 20.3% and with large pores ranging in size from 100 micrometer to 300 micrometers. The presence of pores of this size in the coatings of implant can contribute to the invasion of blood vessels into the pores of the coating, positively affecting the formation and nutrition of bone tissue, and therefore the fixation and also integration of the endoprosthesis in the human body. Let's take another look at the dependence of porosity on spraying parameters. The regression equation 2 was obtained for the dependence of porosity of coatings on MPS parameters. The experimentally measured porosity has been used to calculate the numerical values of the coefficients in the equation 2. And once again, the main parameters controlling the porosity of zirconium coatings are the electric current and the plasma gas flow rate. Thus, the possibility of microplasma spraying on zirconium coatings onto titanium substrates was established, and the influence of MPS parameters on the microstructure of zirconium coatings has been established with the use of scanning electron microscopy. Conclusion. The correlation between the porosity of zirconium coatings and the MPS parameters has been established. It has been established that the main parameters controlling the size of the spraying zirconium particles and the porosity of zirconium coatings are the electric current and the plasma gas flow rate. The ability to control the porosity of microplasma coatings from zirconium wire in the range from 2.8% to 20.3% due to changes in the MPS parameters was established. The parameters of MPS of zirconium wire for the formation of coatings with porosity up 20.3% and porous sizes up 200 micrometers have been established. The results of the research are of significance for a wide range of researchers developing the technologies of thermal plasma spraying or biocompatible coatings. Naturally, the question arises about the roughness of microplasma zirconium coatings. Regarding the roughness, it strongly depends on the spraying parameters. With runoff 7 and 8, it's greatest, over 50 micrometers. But the analysis of the dependence has yet to be done. We plan to continue research and conduct a series of coating tests, such as standard tests for adhesion strength, corrosion resistance tests, biocompatible tests. We are also going to do the microplasma spraying of hydroxyapatite coatings onto zirconium sublayer. and microplasma spraying of hydroxyapatite coatings onto sintered porous titanium substrates. In addition, we plan to apply the new software developed by us to control the robotic arm in order to increase the accuracy of MPS of coatings onto implants with complex shapes. Thus, this is an ongoing study, and there is still much to be done. However, this study has already confirmed the applicability of the scanning electron microscope technique for characterizing zirconium coatings and selected spraying parameters. In conclusion, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Ukrainian scientists Sergei Voinarovich and Oleksandr Kislytsa, and to my colleagues from East Kazakhstan Technical University, Dr. Prokhorenkova Nadezhda and Dr. Alexander Krasavin, for their work on this research. The authors gratefully acknowledge funding from the Science Committee of the Ministry of Education and Science of the Republic of Kazakhstan, under grant number AP05130525. I am also extremely grateful to the organizers of the Congress for the opportunity to discuss this research, and I am ready to answer any questions about it. Thank you for watching this.
Thank you, Professor Daria Alamseva, to her nice and very interesting pre-recording research presentation. Professor, are you here? If you are here, we can take you to a conference. We can open your voice to take your questions easily. Yes, I think she's not here. If any participant have any question about this presentation, you can send an email to Professor Daria Alamseva. And as you see that, she's going to answer your questions. And we are going to start our next presentation, Hümeyra Orucu, but about 10 minutes later. Professor, are you here?
Yes, I am here.
Hello, how are you?
Thank you so much.
We have 10 minutes. 10 minutes later, we are going to start your pre-recording. Presentation.
Okay. Okay.
Professor Dalria Alonseva, do you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Hello.
Hello, welcome. 2 minutes before, your presentation has just finished. Yes, just now we are in the question part. Mm-hmm. Yes, I want to ask again to all our participants. Do you have any questions? Our professor came here only to answer your questions. Thank you again, Professor.
Okay. So I'm glad to see you and all other participants of the conference has finished my work at university in Jordi. Mm-hmm. No questions.
I think there is no question for now. And okay. Also, end of your presentation, all of the participants can see that your email address, and also we are going to announce all our participants' contact email address after the Congress. As I said before, you didn't hear. If someone have any questions, and also I want to warn all our participants again, if participants have any questions after the Congress, they can ask you as an email.
Yeah, thank you so much.